Before the Salem witch hysteria of the late 17th century, a woman in western Massachusetts was subject to three different witchcraft-related trials. Her name was Mary Bliss Parsons.
Mary Bliss Parsons had the first recorded birth in Northampton. That's her son Ebenezer in 1655. Sarah Bridgman had the first recorded death, which was her child. And before her child died, she had kind of a supernatural experience. She was holding a child in her lap, and she heard a knocking at the door, and she looked out, and she saw two women in white that were passing, but her daughter then looked out and said that there were no women there. So she had seen something kind of spectral, and she said that in that moment, her baby changed, and that it became sick, and it died. And she believed that Mary Bliss Parsons was responsible for that. So at that point, the accusations started to kind of snowball. Some people accused her of some mundane things, like that she ruined their yarn. They were spinning yarn for her and it came out full of knots. One of the big accusations was she had an argument with a man and the next day his cow died. So with all these different happenings around town that were creating this story around her. So Mary Parsons' husband, Joseph Parsons, then he decided he was going to take some action. So he accused Sarah Bridgman of slander, and there was a slander trial. Ultimately, Mary Bliss Parsons was acquitted. Even though she was acquitted, the sort of suspicions never really went away. Then it was years later, her Ebenezer, the son who I spoke about before, her son Ebenezer died in 1675, and people were saying that it was retribution for her having never been punished as a witch. The next episode in this drama comes in 1674. Sarah Bridgman had passed away, and this was the point where her daughter Mary followed her. She was a young woman, so her passing was not entirely expected, and Sarah Bridgman's husband felt that Mary Parsons was involved. So at this point, it became an official witchcraft accusation. Mary Parsons was examined and she was put in jail in Boston during the trial. She was acquitted again, and she returned to Northampton, but this was sort of the last straw for her and Joseph, and she and Joseph moved to Springfield. Because they had been sort of dogged by these accusations for, at this point, 20 years. 1702, a enslaved woman named Betty struck Mary Bliss Parsons' grandson, and she told him, she said, your grandmother is a witch, and she has killed three people. So this is definitely something people believed, even sort of despite her in some ways being acquitted twice. 1711, in some ways, the feud dissipated because Mary Bliss Parsons' granddaughter married Sarah Bridgman's grandson. So there's a real economic component to this as well. Mary Bliss Parsons, as we said, Mary Bliss Parsons was quite well off for the time, and in some ways that insulated her from some of the consequences. We believe that she was able to be made more comfortable in jail, and it meant that she already had connections in the legal world when she was tried.